Nice one, cool, nice. Well done everybody, well done. Thanks for tuning in everybody, here we go. My name's Cornelius and this is the Cornelius Corkery Trio, and I better introduce us all. On the guitar, we've got Andrea Vergani. Give him a round of applause. Audience, everyone, loving it. And on the bass, we've got Joe Downard. Give him a loving it, so thanks for tuning in. Thanks to Toby for having us here. It's really nice to get to play. And thanks for having tuning in. Thanks to Toulouse Trek for having us. And thanks to all the many plentiful audience in here to listen to us play. So that was a nice ballad that I wrote a long time ago. It's called For Loon. I think we're going to settle with that one.
Yeah, nice one.
Some of these tunes I literally still haven't named yet, so I'm going to be thinking of names as we go through the set list. So we're going to do some originals. We're going to do some Django tunes. Going to do some whatever, different tunes you might know. Let's do a Django tune. This one's called Fletch Door. Flesh. I don't speak French, if you couldn't tell. And Toby tells me this means golden arrow. Now, he could have stitched me right up there. I don't know. I don't speak French, but maybe it means golden arrow. Here we go. Fletch Door by Django Reinhardt.
All righty. Nice. That's good, that one.
Yeah.
Good. Thank you.
There it was, Flesh Door, The Golden Arrow. Nice one. It's good, isn't it? Good Django tune. It's not a very commonly called out one, but it's I'm quite fond of it. So now we're going to do another one of my tunes. Now, I wrote this tune pretty much, like finished it like a good few years ago, like 5 years ago when I was living in York. And the story goes, I'm walking down a street, I think it was Coney Street, one of those nice cobble streets in York, and there was a really lovely lass. I mean, she was a stunning girl, absolutely banging. And I see her, I think, oh, she's brilliant. And she walked into a charity shop. This is a true story. I might have told you, I don't think I've told you. She walks into the charity shop, and I think, well, I haven't been to the charity shop for a while. I think I'll have to wander in, have a look. I'll go in and introduce myself, you know. And I went in, but the first thing I saw when I was looking after this girl was this fantastic pair of brogues, swanky-looking brogues. And they're only a fiver, £5. Well, like typical Yorkshireman, the girl is forgotten about and thought, bargain, £5 for shoes. That's well good, isn't it? So I got these brogues, and they looked really good, but in the end, there was a reason they only cost a fiver. Because I'd be out wearing them on a night out, and then if it was raining, you know, if it was kind of wet on the, you know, street, when I come downstairs in the morning, and the shoes would be there by the door, and there'd be this little light layer of mold just over the shoes, because the water had kind of soaked in through the crappy soles on these shoes, and they'd just be, you know, and you just clean them off, and then away you go, you know, you wouldn't matter, but it was just a funny image coming down with a sore head and seeing your swanky shoes with a kind of white kind of glaze over them, you know. Anyway, so I wrote this tune. I was looking for a name for it, and I kind of thought, I don't know, the image kind of suits the tune. I don't know. You tell me. But here we go. This tune is called Moldy Brogues. Right? Have I told you that story before?
No. Not that one. Not the one.
Yeah, it's true. It's interesting. All true. 100% true. All right. Are you ready? Thank you. There it was, Moldy Brogues. Very good. Now then, if you're watching at home, which presumably you are, unless you're out and about, there's a little donation button somewhere on your computer screen or on your phone. If you fancy sending us a little bit of cash for a pint of beer or some new shoes or whatever, the ones that have mold on, don't be shy. Chuck us a bit. It'll be super appreciated for us poor beggars, musicians. You know, it's a tough old gig being a musician, isn't it, right?
It's tough life.
Tough gig. Cool, all right. Well, we're going to do another one of my compositions now. Still need a name for this one, lads. I think we're going to go for a working title. This isn't going to be the real name, but for reasons that I've explained to these chaps earlier on, this tune is called The Siege of Malta. There you go.
Maybe we'll stick with it. I don't like that.
Very mysterious. The Siege of Malta.
Hey, it's a hell of a siege. All right, take it away, Andrea.
Nice. Yeah, nice.
Yep.
There it was.
The good old bossa.
So, I like that, the siege of Malta. It kind of works. Yeah, yeah. Do you know what I mean? It's, it's got us.
The concept of bossa and siege of Malta go together. It's an inexplicable way. Yeah.
In a way. I was feeling it, man. I was feeling it. All right, then. So, yeah, that's a few of my tunes. We've done a bit now. Now we'll do some more familiar stuff. I think, did Fat Swallow write this one?
He did, yeah.
Yeah, this is written by Fat Swallow. It's called Please Donate Generously. No, this is called Honeysuckle Rose. Who needs six strings, any?
Right,
I've had to go change that string. All right, then. After a quick bit of maintenance, we're ready to rock. You see, poor musician, I need new strings, so donate wherever you are. We're going to do a really cool tune now called Kali Sara, and Andrea's going to tell us about it because he knows a bit more about it than me.
Yeah. Tell us a bit about this tune, Andrea.
Here you go. So, yeah, Kali Sara, it's a tune from a beautiful movie from the 90s, and the movie is called Lato Drum. And it's about the gypsy, all the histories of the gypsies, how they came from India all the way through Central Europe and then France and Western Europe. And this is a tune I really love. It's a tune dedicated to the patron saint of the gypsy, Sara. And if you look it up online, if you find the movie, watch it, because you're going to find a super all-star lineup of musicians playing it. You have Dorado Schmidt, Chavalo Schmidt, they're all there, and Horn of Interstan, yeah. And it's a beautiful tune, and we want to dedicate this to the inspiration behind Gypsy Jazz, which is the music from the gypsies. So here we go, Kali Sara.
Beautiful stuff. It's cool that film in it because there's a festival, isn't there?
Yeah.
On the beach or something.
Yeah, it's a place by the sea.
Yeah, and in the film, like, they're all there, and there's just loads and hundreds, maybe like 1,000 too, or so, on the beach, and they're carrying the kind of statue of Sara through on this like procession. And it's a hell of a scene because it's thunder and lightning on the beach, and it's wild, like. And then they go into this cave and they play this tune to a statue of St. Sara. Beautiful stuff. Lacho Drama is a film. You should definitely check it out. Cool. Now then. Ah, yeah. So from high culture to pop culture. This is a tune that I really like because it was on an advert for like a car, like Honda in like the 90s or something. And it's just a pretty catchy tune. It was recorded by Andy Williams. It's called Music to Watch Girls By. Thank you. nice one. It's a good tune, that. Big fan. All right, so that's a couple of covers. Let's do another original. This was actually written by a friend of mine in York, a guy called Mattia Cordia. And I don't know if you watch Mattia, but I hope you're doing well, mate. Mattia, I think, is in Granada now. But we used to hang out in York playing tunes and chasing women and drinking pints and having a nice time. And he wrote this little tune for me, and it was a nice little tune, and he called it Corn Dog's Corkscrew, because Corn Dog's a bit of a nickname. And I better just clear this up as well. So my name on my birth certificate is Cornelius Corkery. That's what it was called. It was called after my granddad, Cornelius. Neil is for short, and that's what my parents call me. But there are people out there, I think they generally think there's two of us. There's a Cornelius Corkery and a Neil Corkery. Both gypsy jazz guitar players, handsome fellas, but never on the same gig, you know. There's just one of us, it's me, and my official name's Cornelius, but you can call me whatever you want. Some people call me Corn Dog, and this is Corn Dog's Corkscrew. All right.
Nice one.
Yeah.
Oh. And this is for Mattia. Hope you're doing well, mate. Cheers.
Okay, one, two, three. Thank you.
Joe Downard on the bass. Loving a bit of that. Loving that, loving that. Yeah, that's for my mate Mattia. Hope you're doing well, pal. Alrighty, what have we got next? So this is a tune written by a really strange guy. He had lots of very weird habits, he'd only eat like beige white food and stuff, and he had this ridiculous timetable where he had to do walks at certain times of the day, regardless of weathers, and if he didn't go, he'd go nuts. He was a French guy, so we're already talking pretty weird, right off the bat. Really old composer, Eric Satie, and despite being such a maniac, really, he wrote some really lovely, sweet, gentle music, and this is one of his tunes. It's called Gymnopédie Number 1.
Loving it. Thank you.
beauty, beauty.
Great tune.
Great tune by a weird man.
Cool, we're nearly there, guys. We're nearly at the end of it all. So thanks again for watching. Chuck us a bit of money if you fancy it. Think of it as buying us all a pint, you know. And if you live in Scotland or something, like £2 doesn't cut it in London. You need a little bit more if you can afford it.
3 times as well.
Yeah, literally, yeah. But yeah, honestly, anything you can afford is cool. Much appreciated. I really hope you're enjoying the music. That's the main thing, because we're enjoying it. So hope you're enjoying it too. All right, is one of mine. Oh, I haven't got a name for this one. This could have been Siege of Malta, to be fair, couldn't it? The waltz.
The sequel.
The Battle of Lepanto. That came a bit after the Siege of Malta. Yeah. But I don't know. Do I really want like a Crusades theme to all my, you know? For now, this is going to be called Waltz, I think. But anybody got a good name, have a listen, put it in the chat. You know, the winner gets my, you know, respects. Cool. So all names, suggestions, do send them in. Lovely, that was Waltz Untitled. Send in your requests or whatever you want that tune to be called, because I can't think of a title. Now, we're nearly there, lads. We're going to do a really beautiful tune. This is called Miro Django. It's written by the great Dorado Schmidt, who's really one of my absolute favourite guitar players in the scene. I think he really has everything that is sort of best about Gypsy Jazz. He's just got that style that, you know, you can't quite name it, but he's just got it. And this is one of my favorite tunes he ever wrote. It's called Miro Django. Let's give it a lash. Nice, very good, cool. Here we go, just as the cops are coming, we've got one tune left. So that was Miro Django by Gerardo Schmidt. Quickly, we've got Andrea Vergani on the guitar, give him a round of applause, lovely job. Joe Downard on the bass, loving it. My name's Cornelius, thanks for watching. Thanks for watching. I really hope you've enjoyed it. We're going to be recording some of these original tunes soon on Toby Medland's record label thing. Very prestigious, so watch out for that. Thanks to Toby. Thanks to Toulouse Trek. Thanks for watching. Thanks, everybody. This is the last tune. It's a Django composition. It's called Duke and Dukey. All right. Yeah. Nice one. Thank you.